Let's discuss the relationship between LSQ entries, ROB entries, and reservation stations. When we issue a load or a store instruction, we need a ROB entry. Every instruction needs a ROB entry. So when we issue a non-load store instruction, we also get a ROB entry, and we get, for a non-load store instruction, a reservation station of the right type. For loads and stores, instead, we get a LSQ entry. These act as reservation stations for loads and stores. So note that we cannot issue a load or a store unless we have both a ROB entry available and an LSQ entry available, just like we couldn't issue a non-load store instruction if we didn't have both a ROB entry available and the reservation station of the right type available. When we execute a load store instruction, there are actually two parts to that execution. First, we need to compute the address. Second, we need to produce the value. For a load, that means we first compute the address, then we get the value from memory. For a store, actually, this can happen in any order. We are computing the address while we are also trying to obtain the value of the register that we need to store to memory. We write the result only for loads. For a store, there is no write of the result. The store simply keeps the value and the address in the load store queue for other loads to get it and for the store to finally send it to memory on commit. But the load, as soon as it gets the result, will broadcast that result to dependent instructions so that pretty much all the reservation stations that are waiting for that register value can now proceed. So note that our load store unit, although it doesn't have reservation stations, it has the load store queue. So when it finally figures out the value for the load, it needs to broadcast it to subsequent instructions so that they can be woken up and use that value. They will get that value from the load store queue. To commit a load, we move the ROB head, basically we free the ROB entry, and we also move the LSQ head, that is, we free the LSQ entry. And we need to do the same thing for stores. For stores, in addition to this, we have to send the write to memory. Pretty much we've been holding on to the address and the value until we commit the store, so at the time when we commit it, we need to finally send that value to memory.